Okay, first thing we want to do is to import the GPS data that we have logged to our SD card. So I'm going to open and I'm going to search for all types, then go to my removable disk, the SD disk. Here is the file. I'm going to say open. And it's going to be a comma delimited file, so I'm going to say delimited, next. I'm going to click on comma only and deselect everything else, and I'm good to go. Finish. Okay, so we have lots of data. I think I have over about 9,000 points. I'm not going to plot all of it. Basically what I have here, I have some garbage that I have to clean up, but this is the X data, this is the Y data, this is the Z data. These three row values were generated by the ADXL335 accelerometer. This is the GPS sentence type, it's the RMC type, and basically it's giving me the universal time, whether it's valid. A means valid sentence, V means invalid. This is the altitude, latitude, heading, longitude, heading. I believe this is speed. This is degrees, date, and additional data that we're not going to use here. First thing I'm going to do, I'm going to hide the columns that I'm not going to be using. I'll be using only the Z axis data and latitude and longitude. Everything else is going to be hidden. So I'm going to start by multiple selecting the columns that I will not be using. And then I'm going to right click and hide. Just in case I have any stray data, I'm gonna delete. Okay, now, next thing, I'm going to delete all the rows with invalid data and missing data, such as this one. I should be having three columns now. Okay, so right click, delete entire row. Okay, I see some gaps here. I'm going to delete them also. This could be the result of driving through a tunnel, possibly. Okay, and I can go on with this until my data is cleaned up. Next thing, I'm going to insert a row at the top for my header. I'm going to name this column N, and this is latitude, and this is longitude. Okay, now I'm ready to copy a selection from this cleaned up Excel spreadsheet to paste it into gpsvisualizer.com. This is gpsvisualizer.com. It's a wonderful website if you're doing any data mapping. In our case, we're interested in plotting data points. We have captured sensor data and we wish to plot our location data along with the captured z-axis data. So we go to plot data points page. And here, all we have to do is just paste our data in this box. So we're going to delete everything here, go to Excel, and then select the range. We have to select the headings, the column headings. It's important. If you try to type them into GPS Visualizer, you run into all sorts of formatting issues and error messages. So we're going to capture the title and paste it into GPS Visualizer along with the range of data that we wish to plot. I've cleaned up the data for the most part. I still have some gaps, but I'm not going to spend too much time on this. In the real world, I'll develop a macro in Excel to do to do the cleaning. Oops, I missed the selection. Okay, so now I'm gonna copy the selection, go to GPS visualizer, I'm going to paste it. Before I do any manipulations here with the data point options, I'm just going to plot the data as is. Guess you have N latitude, longitude. So let's do draw the map. Okay, if my data is formatted appropriately for GPS visualizer, it will go ahead and plot the path. Here we have it. Okay, so here it shows the points. If I click on any of those red disks, it will give me the N value, which is the Z-axis data. Okay, good enough. Now, you know, great, but I wish to see these icons change in size and color according to the value of N, which is my Z-axis data, the shakiness data. So let's close this and go back. Okay, now I know that I wish to colorize using the N field, okay, and I wish to colorize based on a minimum data. So the closer the Z data, or the N data is closer to the minimum, the redder the icon will be, and the closer to the maximum, the bluer the icon will be. Now I know from my experience that my data, when I'm driving on a good road stretch, if you look at my Z data, I'm hovering around maybe 510 for my minimum, 515. I see a lot of 510, 515, so maybe 5. I'll start with 500 just to be on the safe side. So I'm going to say 500 for my minimum data. Okay, for my maximum, if I scan my data, I will see numbers go as high as, of course, I could have done these calculations in Excel looking for my minimum and maximum. Okay, let's see. I'm seeing 23 here. And 27. Okay, I'm going to play it safe. Okay, I see really low numbers. Okay, so I'm just going to say 550. And then my minimum radius for my icon is 6 pixels, my maximum 16 pixels. I'm going to keep those for now. I can change them later. Let's see. And for icons, I'm going to pick small stars. And that's okay for now. Draw the map. Okay, so here I'm seeing some coloration. Most of it is right in the middle. So most of my points are hovering around the 520 plus. If I zoom in a little bit, I'll be able to see more variations in the colors and the stars. So the bluer numbers, that means I'm closer to the higher end of the spectrum. That means there's a road bump. The smaller and the greater the numbers means there's some turbulence here. So if I go to this blue star over here, okay, and if I click on it, I get 541. That's pretty significant. Small one here, the red is 502. 502. Okay. This number is obviously small, it's off the range, it's 499. Wow, this is very small. Okay. 536. 542, and this is of course greater than my maximum range of colorization, so it's 552. Major bumps here. Okay. And this is a smooth stretch of roads here for the most part. Ah, here's a bump here. 542. Probably some deleted data during my Excel data massaging. Okay, we get the point. And that's all there is to it.